Yeah, let me talk about reinforced cement concrete water tanks. This is the introductory lecture, lecture number 1. So let us begin. The water tanks are used to store water. The basic principles and methods of water tank design may also be applied to other similar structures like swimming pools, basement walls, maybe settlement tanks in water or sewage treatment plants, etc. The principles may also be equally applied to a storage of liquids having different densities. The tanks storing penetrating liquids like petrol, acids, hot liquids may also be designed with the same principles which are used to design the water tanks. However, the allowable crack width for such structures will always be limited as compared to normal water retaining structures. Now coming to types of water tanks. So first, the classification is done based on placement of tank. If the tank is resting on ground, it is called as the resting on ground tank, or in other words, it is also referred to as GSR, that is ground storage reservoir. Again, if the tank is constructed under the ground, or below the ground rather, it is called as underground tank, or sometimes it is referred to as USR, that is underground storage reservoir. The third type is elevated tank, that is sometimes it is called as ESR, elevated storage reservoir, or even if it is referred to as HGLR, that is high ground level storage reservoir. Now based on the shape of tank, it can be classified as circular water tank, rectangular water tank, spherical water tank, Eames tank, or conical bottom. Here in these two photos we can see the water tank resting on ground. This is the first photo, and the second photo is the underground water tank, that is a tank constructed below the ground. Now this is the elevated water tank, these are circular water tanks, this is the plan view of rectangular water tank, this is a spherical water tank, this is inch type, whereas this is a conical bottom water tank. Now moving further, Indian standard 3370/2009, part 1 and part 2 is nothing but code of practice concrete structures for storage of liquids. Part 1 talks about general requirements, whereas part 2 talks about the design of RCC liquid retaining structures, that is water tanks. However, the code permits two design methods. One is limit state method and other one is working stress method. We will design the water tanks by working stress method. The geotechnical investigations of the site is always required, because the soil type up at foundation level not only affects the foundation design but also affects the forces on various elements of the tank due to earthquake loads. Effects of differential settlement have also to be considered. If subsoil water also exists, it may adversely affect the allowable bearing pressure and may also induce the forces in the elements of underground structures. And therefore, minimum 10 meter deep boreholes of around 150 mm diameter, that is 6 inches diameter, shall be taken to determine the soil properties at foundation level before the construction of water tank. If corrected N value, that is SPT value, that is standard penetration test value, is less than 15, then the ground shall be properly compacted so that N value greater than 15 can be obtained, and other measures also can be simultaneously taken. Or if the ground improvement is not possible, then pile foundation going to stronger strata may also be adopted on the site. Under subsoil water level condition, The foundation and underground structure shall be checked for uplifting possibility as well. That means because of the subsoil water, there may be buoyancy effect on the water tank, and therefore the check against the uplifting force or uplifting pressure should be always carried out. The chemical properties of soil shall also be investigated to check the presence of sulfates or other harmful chemicals in soil that may corrode the reinforcements. In corrosive environment, sometimes corrosion resistant steel, which is known as CRS, is highly recommended, especially near the coastal area, that is near the sea. The construction joints and moment joints must be properly detailed using quality water stops. Construction of water retaining structures in waterlogged area or inside water requires proper dewatering process. Sheet piles may be provided and dewatering may be adopted for casting underground structures and foundations underwater. Now let us see the special considerations to be given stress upon in connection with water tank. Number one, the concrete should be impervious, it should be durable, and it should be maintenance free. The concrete should have good quality for a reasonable service life. Concrete with less permeability always leads to more durability. The durability of concrete includes resistance to damage and protection against the steel corrosion. The liquids stored in underground sumps may be untreated, example raw water sump, or may contain harmful gases. That is in case of sewage settling tanks. Indian standard 3370 gives minimum concrete grade to be used, maximum free water cement ratio, and minimum cement content to be used for constructing water tanks. Badly designed and detailed joints may permit liquid flow, and they shall be avoided during design stage. Second is, the cracking of concrete should be limited to prevent the leakage. Concrete has lot of cracks. Larger the crack width, it permits leakage of liquids, and they shall be strictly restricted. Two types of cracks shall be given special attention. One is cracks due to shrinkage and temperature. These cracks are uniform throughout the depth of the concrete. Such cracks can be limited by resisting the shrinkage and temperature forces by using the steel reinforcement, and therefore minimum reinforcement as suggested by the code takes care of such types of cracks. Next one is cracks due to the applied loads on the tank. These cracks are always wider at the surface. They allow the water to enter into the concrete. The steel may undergo corrosion, which leads to the disintegration of concrete. Therefore, surface cracks shall be limited to a predetermined value as suggested by the respective codes of practice. Very importantly, the Indian standard IS 456-2000 says that surface crack width of 0.3 mm is permitted for normal structures, up to 0.2 mm is permitted for elements exposed to moisture or in contact with soil or groundwater, and up to only 0.1 mm for very aggressive environments such as severe category of exposure. IS 3370-2009 stipulates that for liquid retaining structures, the exposure as severe, and it permits crack width only up to 0.2 mm. This requirement necessitates limiting tensile stresses in concrete to permissible value. That means, since the crack width permitted is only 0.0 0.2 mm. Therefore, this requirement makes it necessary to limit the tensile stresses in concrete to certain permissible value. That means we cannot allow the tensile stress inside the concrete to exceed certain values given in the table of IS 3370 2009. Otherwise, if those tensile stresses exceed the values given in the table, then the crack width will be more than 0.2 mm. That is what the code assumes. The design method developed by considering limiting crack width is known as no crack design, or it is called as uncracked theory. That means we want to design the water tank in such a way that there should not be any crack, and therefore it is called as no crack design or uncracked theory, because cracking in a water tank is always dangerous. Thank you very much.